When you're shopping for a new car, typically there is a section of your checklist where you'll have to accept compromise. Now, that doesn't need to be a bad thing. Case in point is this car here. This is the Lexus RCF, and it's one of the sportiest Lexus entries we've seen in some time from the brand. You have a hot motor, you have sharp styling, but what you don't have is the fastest car. If you stack it up against the competition from Germany and America, you won't be the fastest. You will have a healthy middle ground. But with looks like this, maybe you just don't care. Now, this is Lexus's take on a sporty coupe, and that's a fun place to be. Here, it's extra sporty because it's the RCF. This is not an F Sport. This is the full deal, stonking V8 F. You've got the Lexus Spindle Grill in full aggression. You've got a hood scoop. You've got the great daytime running lights. You come around to the side and you've got these really sharp multi-spoke wheels wrapped in very sticky Michelin rubber. You've got a great vent here and the real F badge to let everybody know that they're not playing with the 350 F Sport, but the real one. And you know, this orange paint helps it stand out a little bit too. Come around to the back, you've got an integrated spoiler. And of course, it wouldn't be a true F without quad tailpipes. Real deal tailpipes, not like the first gen ISF fake stack tailpipes, but the real thing. So let's find out what lies beneath this hood scoop right here, which actually doesn't appear functional. Whatever, sometimes, you know, a little form over function. Here though, we have lots of function in the form of a 5-liter V8 engine making 467 horsepower and 389 pound-feet of torque, and it's backed up by an 8-speed paddle-shiftable automatic gearbox. Now, this is where I start to talk about a bit of the compromise with the Lexus RCF. If you stack this up against of the cars that you're thinking about, be it C63 coupes, E63s, even though that is four doors, BMW M4s, Cadillac ATS and CTS-V. So you start looking in that space, you're gonna start to be down on horsepower. You're either down on horsepower, you're in a decent place on price, so like you're giving up something, but you're getting the looks, you're getting the style, you're getting the enjoyability and the noise that this engine makes, but you're not getting the full level of performance you might get from some of the competition. The outside feels like new Lexus, where inside you'll start to see some familiar Lexus touches. There's a big L badge staring you in the face on the steering wheel. The F looks familiar. You have an analog clock and you have a bunch of letters that add up to the words Mark Levinson. You also have this Lexus touchscreen, which has replaced that goofy mouse thing from before. Where it starts to get a little more interesting are when you look at these seats. This design is forward thinking for Lexus. They're super comfortable and they look good. You've got touches of carbon fiber trim. This long trans tunnel or center stack right here kind of fills the space and makes it feel far more cockpity and less cushy luxury than you're used to with the Lexus vehicle. Now, this vehicle is still comfortable, but it is also clearly focused on being a fun to drive, engaging sports car. So once you do hop behind the wheel and push that start button to fire the 5-liter to life, you'll notice right away that it sounds pretty good. When you're sitting here in this seat, you've got good visibility. At 6'3", I have plenty of room. I don't even think I have the seat all the way back. I don't need it all the way back. So there is plenty of room to be found here for taller gents like myself. Now, I'm just cruising along on this California Canyon Road and it's quiet. If I turned on the music, the Mark Levinson sound system would sound fantastic because it always does. The steering is light and comfortable and easy to use. And that's because I'm in normal driving mode. Now, if I turn this wheel to the right, I enter sport mode. Things heighten up a little bit, various systems tense up, get more sporty. But if I go one more to Sport Plus, the whole damn thing comes alive. You hear the intake noise activate. Now, some of that is going to be piped in fakeness, but I do believe it's actual noise being piped in and not fake noise. It's just being channeled through sound generators or sound tubes. So it's extra noise that you wouldn't normally hear, because these are luxury cars, so they have thick firewall padding and there's sound deadening materials everywhere that want to try to keep that noise out. So Lexus then pipes some of it back in. And we're thankful they do. The steering is still light and comfortable. The throttle is super responsive and the brakes are strong enough to haul you down from speed. Something from BMW would feel a little bit more planted and stable in the canyons. The Cadillac might be a more all-around engaging driving experience, because if you get an ATS-V, it's riding on the new Alpha platform, and if you get a CTS-V, it's bananas crazy with its massive monster motor up front. The Lexus sits somewhere in the middle. You get style, you get looks, but you also get comfort. You get a car that is much more of a grand tourer than a sports car. Yes, it's a full F-badge vehicle, but it's not full-on hooliganism all the time. It's comfortable. You can take people on dates in this thing. You could drive your mother or father-in-law around this and they wouldn't complain that their back hurts and they hate you and they're about to puke in your lap. You don't get that. You can just cruise because it is still a Lexus. Now, granted, you can grab paddles and floor it. Base price for this is around $64,000. This one is $75,000 as equipped, and it's pretty nicely equipped. Some of the competition starts to touch up onto the $100,000 side, so maybe you're saving a little bit of money there. But if you do compare it to maybe the ATS-V, maybe you're spending a little bit over. So it's a tricky spot to be in. You have to really want this car. You don't want to have the fastest in the segment. You want to have this Lexus because you like that it is both comfortable and looks awesome, but also is enjoyable and engaging to drive. So just know that if you spend your $75,000 on this, there are faster vehicles out there. And if you're comfortable with that and you can live with not winning the race, maybe you'll arrive to the finish line with your back not aching and your passenger smiling. And maybe a little bit more tire on the rear end, because those Michelins aren't cheap. But when you want to kick that passenger out and floor it, you can do that too. Bye.